Good morning, dear students. As we had discussed this chapter, hardware and software, where we had discussed about the basic parts of computer, that computer is made up of hardware and software. The physical parts that we can touch and see are the hardware, and the part that is there in the computer but we cannot touch them are the softwares. Hardwares are further divided into three categories: input devices, output devices, and storage devices. Input devices are basically used to give the input to your computer. Like we are giving input through the trackball, which is a kind of mouse, then through scanner, through webcam, and through joystick also. Then talking about the output devices, which are used to get the output from the input from the computer. So that means output devices works exactly opposite towards the input devices. If in input devices we are giving the data to the computer, in output devices we are taking the results, we are taking the data from there. Examples are like monitor, printer, speakers. Using all these three devices, we can get the output from the computer. Then storage devices. These devices are used to store the data in our computer. Like whenever we are using any software, we need to save their files. Either it is a photo or it is a video or anything. So storage purpose ke liye we need a storage device. And that could be CD, hard disk, pen drive. So you can choose any of them to store the data in your computer. Next, we had learned about softwares, which is further divided into two types. One is system software that acts like a driver in a car. That means without it, a computer cannot work. So the examples of the system softwares are Windows, iOS, Android. And remember, students, there can be various versions of the Windows, like Windows 7, Windows XP, Windows 8, or Windows 10. Then the next one is application software. The software which is there in the computer, but without which also our computer can run. It's exactly like there is an AC and there is a music system in our car. But without that also, our car will work perfectly. So these software are used for the specific purposes only, okay? So application softwares are like MS Paint, we use it for drawing purpose, calculator for calculation, Tux Paint again for drawing, and WordPad for typing, okay? So with this, we had covered and revised all the topics of this chapter. Now let us begin with the back exercise. So here you can see your book where back exercise is given, okay? So first of all, we are going to discuss fill in the blanks. As you can see, hints are given over here. So that means you need to choose your answer from these options only, okay? So the first question is the parts of a computer that can be touched and seen. Remember, these are the physical parts which we can touch and see in our computer. So this can be hardware, okay? Which is exactly opposite towards our software. So the answer will be here is hardware, okay? So you must note it down in your book with me. The first answer is hardware. Then next one. The devices used for storing data are called dash. So these devices, when we are using this, we can store our data, okay? So these can be storage devices. And the storage devices can be a CD, it can be a DVD, it can be a hard disk or a pen drive also, okay? So category is known as storage devices. Okay, so next, the devices that gives the result after processing are called dash. That gives the result means that gives the final output that is going to display the output. Like monitor is displaying the output, then printer or speaker also. So all these devices belongs to which category? Output devices. Okay, so the third answer will be output devices. Next is, a set of instructions given to a computer is called a dash. So whenever we are giving a set of instructions, like in MS Paint, there is set of tools available which we can use to draw the shapes, to draw the different objects, right? Similarly, in the WordPad also, we can bold a word, we can underline that. So there is a set of instructions which we are giving to the computer using mouse, using clicking, using typing. So this is known as softwares, okay? So in the softwares, we can give set of instructions. The last one, the dash manages the overall working of a computer. It's the same one where I had given you the example of the driver in a car, which is going to manage everything. He is going to turn on the AC, can turn on the music system, and can drive the car and can stop or on the engine at any moment, right? So this is a operating system, also known as system software. Okay, so the answer will be operating system. I hope you all are doing with me and on your books. Now let us discuss the true false. What is true false? That means you need to read the statement and then you have to decide whether it is true or it is false. Okay, so let's see. The first question given over here is, the software that can do a specific type of work is called system software. No. System software is like operating system, Windows. So in Windows, we are not just doing a single type of work. We are managing everything, right? So they are talking about only do specific type of work. No, for the specific type of work, we have application softwares. So this statement is false, okay? Then, a scanner is an input device. Yes, it is an input device. Why? Because we can take a digital copy of any page and then give it to the computer. We can display it on monitor using scanner. Scanner helps us to do this task, okay? So scanner is an input device. Third one is, the paint program is used for drawing pictures. Yes, we can draw the pictures in the paint and we can also color it, right? So this statement is again true. Then the fourth one is, a printer is an output device. Yes, as like scanner can scan a copy of a page, printer can print the same copy of the page, okay? So using printer, we can print any image or any text on a piece of paper. So that is why printer is an output device. So this statement is again true. Fifth and the last true false is, the devices that gives us output are called input devices. Not at all. They are contradicting their own statements. See, in the first statement, they are saying the devices that gives us output. And then they are saying these are the input devices, which can't be possible, right? Those who are giving us output should be output devices, right? So that's why this statement is false. Okay. Now let us move towards match the column. Yeah, it's really fun to do the match the columns, right? Okay. So here we are going to write, we are going to match it actually. Okay. So you can also take your scale and your pencil so that you can match the correct pair of the answers. Okay. First, we are having input devices. So we need to match it with these options, any one option. Okay. So input devices. Printer, no, printer is output device. Hard disk, no, it's a storage device. Songs, no, this cannot be an input device. This number, no, this is the data or the information, but cannot be input devices. We are talking about devices. Keyboard, yes, keyboard is a input device. Let's match it. Next. We already know all the options, so now we don't need to read all the options again. We can directly see which option will be suitable for the given question. So data, obviously these are all not a data. So data can be what? This 90 plus 85 this can be a data, right? So we are going to match it with this. Then we are having storage devices. Hard disk is a perfect example of the storage devices. So let's match it. Hard disk. Okay. Then hardware. Now we are having two options, hardware and software. And one we are having printer, and then another we are having songs. Obviously, we cannot touch and see the songs, right? We cannot touch the songs, but we can touch the printer. So printer will be hardware and songs will be software. Okay. So let's match it. This is our hardware, printer, and songs is our software. Okay. So this is how we need to match. Input devices is keyboard, data. Let's write the numbers also. Let's give the number ABC to this, or you can also give 1, 2, 3. So I'm writing 1, 2, 3. You can also use this strategy so that it can't be messy over here. Okay. So the first answer is keyboard. So we are going to write a number 1 over here. Okay. This can be the another technique to write down your answers in the matchings. 2 is this. Second answer is data. So this one. Third answer is hard disk. So number 3 hum yahan pe likhenge. Fourth is printer. So number 4 hum yahan pe type kar rahe hain beta. Last is software. So songs is the software. So number 5 we will type with the songs. Okay. So this will be the sequence of the matching. Right. Okay, then next we are having application based question. In these application based question, they are asking about a situation, and then we need to decide what we can do. Okay. Kabir wants to record a song in the computer. He wants to record a song. Okay. Must read this word carefully, record. He wants to record a song. Which input device he will use? So for recording purpose, we are having microphone, right? Microphone is the input device that can help us to record our own voice or any song or anything, right? So here he is going to use microphone. They are asking about which input device he can he use? Microphone. Fine. Next, Sheena wants to draw a greeting card using a specific software. So which type of software will she use? Look at this word. She wants to draw a greeting card. She don't want to type it. If it is, she wants to type a greeting message, then it will be Notepad or WordPad. But she wants to draw it. So here we are going to use MS Paint. Okay. For the drawing purpose, we are using MS Paint. Clear? Yeah. So this answer will be MS Paint. Next, we are going to discuss these questions. Name the devices used for each of the following jobs. Okay. A device commonly seen in the video parlors for playing games. There is a specific device for this purpose, which is just used for playing games, for nothing else. Okay. For playing the games, they had designed it for this purpose only. So that is joystick. I'm sure you have seen this device, joystick, which is used in the game parlors to play the video games, right? Next is a device used to record our voice and other sounds in the computer. We had just discussed this above, where Kabir wants to record a song. So here also it will be the same device. For the recording purpose, we are using the same device. It will be microphone or mic, okay? Then a device that can read words, pictures, or numbers from a paper and store them in a computer. Now there is a device जो हमारे page पे जो भी लिखा होता है उसकी एक digital copy create करके हमें अपने PC में store करने में help करता है, right? We can see that digital copy of that paper, and that device is scanner. Okay, scanner is a device that helps us to create a digital copy of any page. Okay, we are going to put the page in the scanner. It is going to scan it, and then we can see the digital copy of that in our computer. Okay, so the answer will be scanner. And there could be anything. It could be picture, it could be words, it could be numbers, it could be anything. Okay, scanner is going to scan it. Next is a device used to hear the sounds and music stored in a computer. Now हमने माइक्रोफोन की हेल्प से उसको रिकॉर्ड कर लिया. It's the time to listen to it. We want to hear it. Okay? So for listening purpose, we are having a device known as speaker. It's always in the pair, so we are going to write S also. Speakers. Okay? So dear students, we had discussed all these devices. I hope you have done it in your book, right? And in the next class, we are going to discuss our question answers. Okay? So be ready for that. Till then, take care.